Chedda Connect in the building. Right now you tune in to hotnewhiphop.com. Catch and play. Look at the Flicka Da Wrist. We started with the streets. You know what I'm saying? That's how we reached out to the people first. You know, we went out there, I pressed up probably about 5,000, 6,000 mixtapes, and I just gave them to everybody. And I was just trying it out, you know what I'm saying? It's a new song, and it's my first, you know, to get my feet wet. So I just tried it out, and I got a lot of good feedback. So when the feedback started coming back good, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna take it more serious. Now I'm finna make this as a single, you know, because I had like I think it was 17 track. That was my first Catch and Play CD, 17 track CD, 18 track CD, one of them. And Flicka Da Wrist was number two on there. And that was the most popping song off the tape. That's where everybody kept tweeting, talking about. So I was like, okay, let me go ahead and make this a single. Let me go back and clean it up. You know what I'm saying? And put a service pack together for it, different things like that. So then we moved to the internet with it. And once we moved to the internet, well, really it moved to the internet alone. And we just started catching a wave from the internet, Vine, Instagram, Twitter. And then we just like, man, let's go ahead and start reaching out to some of these people. So they start tweeting it and inviting it. So when people start, like, I forgot his name, shit. Good friend of T. Wayne, Nike Boy Swoosh, good friend of T. Wayne. When he popped the video off, I ain't gonna lie, him and White Boy Chris, they popped it off. When they did their vines, then everybody just started following along right after that. And next thing you know, it was like an instant thing. Every time you see somebody whipping, they look at this, look at the wrist. Every time you see somebody cooking, flipping pizza, anything. You know, look at the Flicka Da Wrist, watches, and then it just starts spreading like a virus. I'm for the song right now. Whoop, 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 whoop. Yeah, you gotta be on beat for sure. You gotta be on point with it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Some people, they like to get their watch and do like this, you know what I'm saying? But when you on point, when the beat drop, look at the Flicka Da Wrist, look at the Flicka Da Wrist, look at the Flicka Da Wrist. No, that's how we do it, man. Everybody already know, man, when that beat drop, it's straight turn-up time, man. I just seen the club go crazy. I just seen the bouncer accidentally start dancing in there. He forgot he was doing his job. He just started turning up on accident. I'm like, hey, man, got a good reaction, man, for real. They was live out there. They were very supportive, man. It wasn't nobody just sitting there looking like, who is this guy? Or I ain't even going to give him a chance. I'm going to be hard on him. Everybody supported. They put their wrists in the air. When I said put them wrists in the air, I'm talking about literally out of 7,000 people, 6,999 did it, for sure. You know what I'm saying? So, we was out there catching players yesterday, man. Shout out to Summer Jam. Shout out NYC. Shout out New Jersey, man. Shout out Hot New Hip Hop, man. Hey, you know it's Justin Bieber, for sure, because, I mean, that's something that I never thought would happen. You got to get big for even just to recognize your shit. So, that was a salute. That's a major salute right there, man. And then Lil Weezy, man. Lil Wayne, man. Come on, man. That's my nigga, man. Hey, I ain't met Wayne yet, but I'm fucking with him, man. Hey, he fucking with me for sure. Wayne turning up every single time, man. Like I say, I've been watching Wayne, man. Everything, man. Since Block Is Hot. All that shit, man. For real.
Lil B.
I don't really take too serious. You know what I'm saying? I'm a real nigga. I don't really feed into all that internet bullshit. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. But I don't feel like he mean no harm. I just feel like he just trying to get publicity. I just feel like he want to be back in the face, man. Who don't want to be back in the front of the cameras and all that? You know what I'm saying? Get a little bread and shit. But, hey, I don't really take him serious. You know, it ain't nothing. For real, I mean, we street niggas at the end of the day, so we know how to handle it the right way if anything was to pop off. We just dropped Chedda World. Chedda World, you can go get that right now, hotnewhiphop.com. And right now, I mean, I structured that CD to have not just one thing about Chedda, but multiple things. Like, I like women, you know what I'm saying? I like cars, I like money, like all kinds of stuff, traveling. So I put everything in one. So, but right now, the next single that we're putting out is going to be Twinkle. We did it for the women, you know what I'm saying? We reaching out, man. We trying to get these people something to turn up to, man. All that negativity in the club, we don't need all that no more. We trying to turn up, man. We can't keep on bringing our people down, man. You know what I'm saying? I like to see people survive, man. I like to see people getting it, man. I like to see people getting it the right way. You know, I can't change the world, but you know what I'm saying? I can damn sure help make a change, for sure. T. Wayne, that's my little brother, man. That's my little brother. It's more like family now. You know, we met back in MySpace days. I'm talking about a long time ago. That was when Dallas had the whole boogie movement going and everything. And I was doing my rap thing, but I really wanted to be an artist. I mean, I really wanted to be a manager instead of an artist. So I was like, okay, let me reach out to a couple of these young cats and try to put them on their feet. You know, I had a little bread, so I was like, okay. So I went on the internet. I used to go on in and out of time, listen to songs. And then Dallas had the big movement at the time. And T-Wayne had the song called Boogie on the Floor. So at that time, I was like, okay, this little guy right here, he making some noise, man. He was rocking with Polar Hits, but they let him go, you know what I'm saying? So he wasn't rocking with him no more. So I was like, man, it's my chance. So I slid in, I hollered at TJ. T-Wayne was in Waco then. He wasn't in Dallas then, he was in Waco. So I hollered at TJ, TJ plugged it in. Next you know, T-Wayne was moving to Houston, man. We ain't looked back since, man. That was like 6-7 years ago, man. We ain't looked back, we've been rocking. And so, I mean, I put all my time and effort into him, man. For real. Yeah, we got a collab album coming. Before the summer, matter of fact, we trying to drive it like July 4th. We trying to, you know what I'm saying, make everybody on Independence Day, man. You know what I'm saying? We trying to, it's going to be a nice one. It's a nice one for sure. After that, I'm going to work on the album. You know, I'm trying to work on these features, man. I'm trying to construct these songs right. Now, I don't like to just put out anything. I like to put out good music, man, that's going to last and have a value to it. You know, fortunately, Flicka Da Wrist popped out, but I got more behind it. Trust me. Trust and believe. It's going to be the Catch and Plays, the album, baby. That should be like late September, October. That's gonna be a movie for sure. I'm putting my all in on this one right here. It's gonna be a turn up album. I just wanna say, man, Chedda is solid, man. Chedda is he's more than just a rapper, more than just an artist. Chedda is an individual with a dream, you know what I'm saying, that's gonna apply his goals right now. And I feel like this is the platform that God laid out for me, you know, to get away from the streets and to help people change lives, man. You know what I'm saying? That's my calling. Cause I got a big heart, man. I like to see people eating, man. I just like to see, I hate to see someone down, especially if you're in my camp, you know what I'm saying? But I'm the type of nigga to pull up on a homeless nigga and just give him a bag, for sure. I ain't gotta record it, you know what I'm saying? I don't need the publicity. I just did it from the heart. Make sure y'all check me out, man, on Twitter, Instagram, Chedda Da Connect, man. Chedda Da Connect. Hey, make sure y'all go follow me right now. Shout out to E1, man. They put in a lot of work, man. Shout out LMG. We run a game for life, baby.
What was an average day for ASAP Rocky growing up in Harlem?
It depends, because, you know, it was back and forth from, like, Harlem to the Bronx, whatnot. But, like, my hustling days, stages, I would say 13 trying to sell. And the flavor to your air. Which one you ladies gonna make it disappear?
Who got the ganja, no man, time's now. Yo, man, hit my line.
Yeah, baby. Hot new hip-hop shit.
Hot new hip hop shit. See, sometimes.